The other thing too, this is a
Melee going on.
This is a SoCal classic, and this is essentially Melee. Just right now, we're gonna have Falcon. We're gonna have Sheik. They have a little bit of tools to play around with. The side B ledge grab for Falcon. Fantastic change. Thank you. Well, Sakurai started that. So the one thing that we're definitely thankful for from Brawl, no doubt. But yeah, so this matchup.
Was that in Brawl?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, definitely a change that was welcome from all Falcon mains coming from Melee. So that in itself is one of the biggest changes that I think helped this matchup a bit for the edge guarding aspect of it.
Oh, Jake, that's not nice. Don't flip off Marco. Marco's a cool guy.
Okay.
You meanie.
What a bully. Hey, do we have Spider-Man here?
My Spider-Man is not here.
We don't have Spider-Man. Nope. The hero is not here. Can't relinquish.
Word has it that he might make an appearance at Olympus. Word has it. I don't know for sure. But
he may not be the hero
Olympus.
We deserve, but he is the one we need. He just blew a kiss at the camera. Marco's getting sensual with us right now.
We gotta have a quick hand warmer first. As he just overheard Venom.
Alright, and here you all get to see if we get the layout change. Maybe in just a quick sec here.
I'm
gonna
not sure
see
who I favor here.
I would say, just from consistency in this past season, potentially Venom. But then again, I can't really say that too confidently
Marco
because of how often they play.
Yeah, one, they haven't played in like such a long time,
right.
from what I remember. And Venom, he definitely plays a lot more PM, so he's more familiar with PM than Oates is as of recently. Oates, like, he didn't even make the minimum requirement of tournaments for last season. Oh, sorry about that. He only attended four tournaments for the PR. It's five. So even if he did well, he wouldn't have been able to make it onto the PR. But
all right.
Oates,
well,
in Melee, he's definitely like really good. Like he's like one of the more respected Sheiks.
Oh yeah.
And then again, he still doesn't compete that often. Part of the reason why is because he's in LA. He lives in LA now, and there's like little PM smash over there. There's actually no PM smash over there. But I'm not sure how often he actually attends Melee tournaments.
Not too sure. He does do a fair amount of commentary, so he has plenty of kind of experience, at least from the analytical aspect of this. But one thing, noting the tag from Oates, by the way. And normally he plays Green Sheik, but this is a moment where you can't just simply play Green Sheik. You're not the Green Goblin or anything like that.
He also got his Venom's tag, the Wii tag. It's like in reference to how Venom, the actual Spider-Man character, calls himself along with Syndicate? What's the actual black stuff called?
I really couldn't
tell
you.
It's the same name as Venom's old tournament. I can't remember.
Symbiote.
Symbiote. Symbiote.
Yeah.
So that's what Symbiote references to him and his host body is me. Venom always talks as in we, not me, not you.
Right.
We.
We're a big family here.
But so far, Oates has the slight lead on Venom, but Venom.
I love that shield stop. And that's one thing that I don't see too many players use in general, but Venom uses them so
like, I know
often.
He uses them like the most out of like almost any other player I watch. He loves his shield stops.
What was that move? He literally double jumps on the platform, wave lands back, dash grabs down, throw knee, just crisp. I think that's probably my favorite thing about Venom with his play is just, oh no. Yeah, that.
Excellent needles from Oates right there to just keep throwing him out until Venom like mistimed his up B so he couldn't recover.
Yeah, that whole aspect of the matchup definitely makes it difficult. And I think that was a boost grab.
Oh no, that's it. Oh, that should have been it, but Oates getting a second shot at this.
This should be a dead Falcon. And it is. That's a what?
Oates going for the reverse fair, trying to be a little fancy. And he's not losing that much. He definitely is giving Venom another shot at winning, but it's already very tough for Venom to make a comeback because one neutral loss could be his death right now. And he needs to win like four or five times at least to win this set. But oh, I thought he was going to go for the up air. But Oates being a little more patient.
I was thinking a forward air, but there's so many ways right now that Venom could die. But it's just Charmin Ultra. Whoa.
Oates is getting a little.
Such a good recovery.
What's the word I'm looking for? Like, safe with his punishes. Like, he'll get a hiccup from, but then he'll, like, tech flub and, like, do, like, another F-tilt, and which is going to whiff when he could have had a fair to clean up the stock. And now Venom, while he's at 172, he can still do this. Like, a 0 to death is still very possible, especially with a character like Falcon. But Oates squeezes in that fair to take game number one.
Yeah, that forward air is just so... I mean, Sheik doesn't hit that hard, but that is, like, the meatiest slap ever. Just and the angle that it sends at, especially,
the
just makes...
The angle is so bad.
It's so...
By getting hit by...
It's so bad the very second that you just get hit off stage, it's like, oh, well, I can't wait to eat some needles.
Man, imagine if it was stronger, though.
I don't want to have that nightmare in my brain. But anyways, we're going to Battlefield. Fantastic Falcon stage. Sheiks enjoy this stage, but we were talking earlier, Venom absolutely adores this stage, though.
Venom adores this stage. He adores Falcon. I presume those are like his 250 stages.
Yes. Falcon.
Oh, he got the excellent tech, but I don't know what happened with the Nair. That was really weird.
I think maybe he just flubbed on the jump for the tech jump, and he went for the... accidentally pressed A. I'm not too sure how that went. Whew.
I was a bit worried that he went for the Nair instead of the knee immediately, but Venom obviously knows Falcon way more than I do. Still able to have enough time to connect with the knee to clean up that stock.
Right, and here's one thing. Venom actually learned this recently. I had known about it a decent amount, but with Sheik's DI mix-ups, they are true mix-ups, especially at early percentages, but at higher percentages, just hold down.
But, I'm pretty sure you always hold down, and Sheik can never
pretty
chain
much
grab Falcon.
Yeah,
it forces the tech chase, which still isn't that good for Falcon, but it's better than just getting re-grabbed immediately.
Exactly. And
Oates just fell.
I think it's Italian, because that was some pretty thick spaghetti. But there it is, two stocks. That's pretty much it. That's it. But two stocks apiece, looking much better. The confirms, I think, is really if Venom had confirmed a lot better into his knees, a lot better first game, this could definitely go to him. I think that was the biggest problem. He would down throw, and it was easily a knee, but instead he went for a Nair, and he just made the game a lot harder. And Oates dropped some edge guards, so as long as he can clean those up, this could be a 2-0. But again, knee conversions.
Ooh, that knee at 87% and it kills. That's such a good early percent kill for Venom. And especially if he can get like one more good neutral win to add like on 30%, and that's not gonna happen. He'd be like, he would have been like really set to just be one neutral away from taking game number two.
Right.
But having Oates stuck in a corner, well, he had him stuck. But Venom got a little too aggressive and allowed Oates to come back onto stage.
Right, and here's one of the difficult things about the smash up outside of edgeguards for Falcon, is we saw there Venom read the tech roll. He knew right where he was going, but Sheik's tech rolls took her so far that he just missed the down air for the tech chase.
Another thing that I've been seeing Oates do is that when Venom's trying to short hop Nair, Oates is just dashing right under the Nair and he's getting to the other side of Venom and he's able to claim stage position back like that. That was such a crucial moment because Venom was trying to keep Oates stuck in the corner and then he's trying to zone Nair and right as Venom short hopped, Oates ran under him because she crouches really low when she dashes. So able to sneak right under, get on the other side of Venom, and now he's the one who has Venom cornered. And he was able to turn that into a victory in game number two.
A 2-0 for Oates. Venom, I would assume, then gets second in his pool. And actually,
he's got to be Parker. I don't know if.
Oh, yeah.
It looks
actually
like they're going to play. Now, it looks like Oates is looking to get first seed in his pool, beating both the first and second seed in his pool.
Right.